In this segment, we'll talk about what do we mean by rank of a set of vectors. So if you are given a set of, n dimensional vectors. So what that means is that you are given vectors which have n components each in them, then the maximum number of linearly independent vectors is the rank of the set of vectors. So you might be given m vectors which have n, which are n dimensional, and all you have to do is to find out, hey, out of those m vectors, what is the maximum number out of those m vectors which are linearly independent, and that is the rank of the set of vectors. Keep in mind that the rank of set of vectors, it will always be less than or equal to the dimension of the vector, of the vectors. So if somebody says, hey, I'm giving you n dimensional vectors, and whatever the number of vectors they give you of the n dimension kind, the rank of the set of the vectors will be always less than or equal to the dimension of the vectors. It never can be greater than the dimension of the vectors. And we'll see these three things through example. And that's the end of this segment.